A Chinese launch startup is making headlines by creating a reusable stainless steel rocket, apparently drawing inspiration from SpaceX's Starship. Moreover, the rocket will be powered by engines that burn a mix of methane and liquid oxygen propellants, just like Starship's Raptor engines. Let's dive in and see what this new Chinese rocket is all about and how it compares to SpaceX's Starship rocket. Space Epoch, a Chinese launch startup founded by a group of engineers and scientists passionate about space exploration, is behind this new reusable two-stage stainless steel rocket. The rocket's design is heavily influenced by the Starship launch vehicle, which is currently being developed by SpaceX. The Space Epoch rocket will be 64 meters tall and capable of launching up to 6,500 kilograms into a 1,100-kilometer sun-synchronous orbit. In contrast, SpaceX's Starship is almost 120 meters tall and has a maximum payload capacity of 100 tons for a 500-kilometer low-Earth orbit. Starship is constructed out of 304L stainless steel, which has a higher corrosion resistance than regular steel. It is widely used because of the ease with which it can be formed into various shapes. The Space Epoch rocket is made up of thin-walled stainless steel independently developed by Beijing Aero Advanced Technology Company Limited through the research of 23 kinds of domestic and foreign stainless steel materials. Both rockets are constructed in a similar fashion by welding together several stainless steel rings. SpaceX has already built and tested several Starship prototypes, while Space Epoch is currently testing test tanks to validate its stainless steel design before building flight-worthy rocket prototypes out of that material. Stainless steel test tanks with thin walls measuring 3 and 4 meters in diameter successfully passed several hydraulic pressure assessment tests and tests to study fluid movement inside the tank in 2022. What you see here is the common dome that separates propellant tanks and the port through which propellant inside the upper tank reaches the engines. While Starships are powered by Raptor engines, Space Epoch rockets will be powered by Longyun engines. The Longyun engines are manufactured by JiuZhou Yunjian Space Technology Company Limited, a high-tech enterprise integrating the design and development of liquid power systems. Both the Raptor and Longyun use liquid methane and liquid oxygen as propellants. While the Raptor is capable of producing up to 2,300 kilonewtons of thrust at sea level, Longyun produces a maximum thrust of 687 kilonewtons at sea level. The sea level and vacuum variants of Raptor have specific impulses of 327 and 363 seconds, and for Longyun, they are 290 and 350 seconds. Raptor engines have conducted several flight tests before, and so far, the Longyun engines have completed several gas generator hot test evaluations and passed the customer review. According to the manufacturer, all engine systems functioned normally during the hot test run, and the performance indicators of the engine were in line with expectations. The reliability of the ignition system and the speed, head, and efficiency of the turbopumps were also verified by many tests. In order to address issues that could develop from insufficient tank pressure during the rocket recovery process, the Longyun engines have also undergone a number of evaluation tests at very low tank pressures. Similar to the Raptor engines, Longyun engines are capable of multiple starts and thrust adjustments, which are essential for rocket recovery and reuse. Multiple starts refer to the ability to restart liquid rocket engines for vertical recovery. A vertical recovery orbital rocket needs to experience at least 4 ignition processes during its mission. Taking SpaceX's Falcon family of rockets as an example, a ground ignition and takeoff will be followed by a boost back burn after stage separation. Then a reverse thrust deceleration in an excessive wind area, also known as an atmospheric re-entry burn, and a reverse thrust deceleration upon landing. The landing of a rocket according to its established trajectory requires the success of all those engine burns. In addition to the engine's ability to start multiple times, it also needs to adjust the thrust in a wide range to achieve vertical recovery. Raptor engines have already showcased their thrust adjustment ability several times during ground tests and high-altitude test flights. Longyun engine's ground test results have shown that it can be throttled down to 20% of its operating conditions, validating its variable thrust capability and reliability. The first integrated test of the Space Epoch stainless steel test tank and Longyun engine happened a few weeks ago. While the original rocket will have multiple engines in its first stage, the ground test vehicle had a simple design involving a stainless steel tank with propellants and a single Longyun engine mounted on it. If you've been a close follower of SpaceX Starship developments, you've probably seen Starships undergoing static fire tests like this before. According to reports, so far, the Space Epoch ground test vehicle has successfully conducted 3 static fire tests to validate the rocket design. The pre-launch tests included engine ignition, restart, and ignition with low propellant levels. More such tests are anticipated in the coming weeks. Space Epoch is developing rocket prototypes in an iterative manner, much like SpaceX's Starship. The company has also assigned serial numbers to identify its prototypes. XZY-1 was used for the hydraulic pressure assessment tests, and XZH-1D-1 for the recent integrated system test. Their successor, XZH-1D-2, will be used for the first suborbital sea splashdown recovery test later this year. Space Epoch claims that its launcher will be able to be reused up to 20 times. A Space Epoch rocket model featured at the 2022 Zhuhai Airshow exhibition showcased a launch tower, rocket catching and stacking arms, and an orbital launch mount very similar to that SpaceX built at its Starbase facility in South Texas. Perhaps in the future, Space Epoch may try to catch its rockets from mid-air, similar to what SpaceX intends to achieve with Starships and Super Heavy boosters. According to the company, the rocket's targeted markets include point-to-point transportation, space tourism, space station construction, deep space exploration, and planetary defense. Since it is currently in the initial stages of development, not many details are available about Space Epoch's reusable rocket. The company has not yet revealed when the first orbital test flight of the rocket or its scaled-down model is expected. Given that all ground tests to date have been very promising, I believe that once fully developed and in operation, Space Epoch's reusable rocket will have a huge impact on the future of space travel. I will continue to follow the rocket's developments and keep you updated on the latest news. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button, leave a comment, and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you never miss an episode.